Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.
Hello and welcome to another episode of KYC. Today, we are at a campus which is surrounded by this lush green trees, and the moment we stepped in, we were welcomed by the November rains in Chennai. We are at the Great Lakes Institute of Management, and along with me is Ashish Joseph, who is the PGPM student here. Hello Ashish, welcome to KYC.
Yeah, thank you so much.
So Ashish, tell me a bit about yourself.
So the PGPM program is the flagship program that Great Lakes has.
Right.
And the primary requirement is that you have to have work experience before you come to this campus. And personally, I work in the life science industry with a technology firm. And I had 3.5 years of experience. And Great Lakes was one of the best choices that actually I could choose because it fit my criteria in terms of the location that was in, the time frame of the entire the duration of the course, and the specializations that were offered.
What was it like the first day when you came in here, standing in front of this gate and looking at this beautiful sight? Well, how was it?
Yeah, so like the statue says, propelled by knowledge, steered by values.
Right.
I didn't understand in the first place, but eventually when I stepped in and there was a lot of people in the same shoes that I was in, who was coming for the same goal. And one of the biggest deciding factors in which I chose Great Lakes was because of the location that the college was in. And for a top tier college to be in a metro city, it's a big plus point for me. The entire concept of having a 1 year program and be concentrated on the entire stuff has been amazing in this particular location, where you don't have much distraction towards the end of the day. But to actually have fun over here, we have Mahabalipuram that's just nearby, a 5 minute drive.
So you decided to take up PGPM, which is a 1 year course, right? What are the other courses that Great Lakes offers to its students?
So Great Lakes also offers the PGDM program, that is a 2 year classic program that's there.
Right.
And there's PGXPM, which is a program for professionals that are already there in the industry with 8+ years of experience, and PGPM Flex. So the 1 year PGPM program is the flagship program that Great Lakes offers, and it's ranked among the top 5 in the country. And the way that this program is tailored is specifically for working professionals, and everything that is being taught in a 2 year program is being taught in a 1 year program. Right now that I'm in, I'm specializing in AIMLab, which is analytics, machine learning, artificial intelligence. And apart from this course, they also give certifications, and I was fortunate enough to be selected for the PayPal product management program. And for me to actually scale myself to a product manager, to think in terms of different product metrics, in terms of customers, in terms of infrastructure and technology perspective, it's been amazing. And to be certified and to go out in the industry with a PGPM accreditation, it's something that I'm really happy about.
Right. Yeah. So Ashish, it will be a crime if we don't explore this beautiful campus that you guys have. Why don't you show me around? Like, I really am interested and intrigued to know more about this campus.
Definitely. Why don't we just hop on board to our vehicle over there?
Right. Let's go.
Sure.
So Ashish, tell me, why are we sitting in this like a buggy, like a golf cart?
Great Lakes is one of the only platinum LEED rated campuses.
Okay.
And green campuses in the country, and it's one of the first in South Asia.
How does it affect a student's psyche, for example?
When you're looking at a very stressful environment, when you're doing your MBA, deadlines is it's a normal thing for everybody.
Right.
But to be in a campus that actually calms you down with the green atmosphere, it's very good to the mind as well as your assignments as well. I have to mention that. Yeah. Technically, if you're doing an MBA program anywhere, you are going in for it.
True.
It's an unwritten fact that there are sleepless nights. The different projects that we do has a lot of relevance to the industry here, because Great Lakes partners with a lot of corporates in training them professionally in analytics and marketing and business development and innovation. And we also have an incubation cell over here which mentors startups.
Oh.
So in an environment like that, we have a lot of projects that helps us to think from an entrepreneurial standpoint.
Right. How do you guys unwind? So for example, it's very important for a student to not just get into this whole cycle of studies every time, you know? I mean, it's very important to play as well at some time.
So we've got two different sets of activities that are organized by committees and clubs. So from a committee perspective, we have the finance committee, marketing committee, the consulting committee, the sports committee as well. And in terms of clubs, we are trying to foster the special interests that are there. For example, movie appreciation club, photography club, Case Study Club, Debate Club, the Grub Review Club.
Is this a kind of a place where you get food at around 2, 3 at night when you're working on your assignments? And yeah, I mean, how is it?
Yeah, so whenever somebody new comes into Great Lakes, the first thing that they know is Great Lakes never sleep.
Okay.
So for people who don't sleep, what is the primary requirement? Food and coffee.
Right.
So Sodexo is our food vendor over here, mm-hmm. and we have a 24/7 counter that gives us sandwiches, anything to drink, fresh juices, coffee. And I think I've had a good experience for tasting different amounts of food, different types of food over here from Sodexo. And this is our grab-and-go counter. This is where the midnight souls come at 3 a.m., 4 a.m. in the morning in case if they're just done with their submissions. And they just come for a quick cup of coffee or some quick snacks over here. And this is open all the time, and this has been the lifesaver of the campus.
Right. What is the kind of a batch size that you look at?
Okay, so for the PGPM program, we have around 406 students in this current year.
Okay.
And for the two-year PGDM program, we have around 164 students currently studying here.
All right.
And like our founder said, Uncle Bala said, your net worth is your network.
Right.
So around, with this much amount of people studying in the campus at the same time, it's actually a plus factor
mm-hmm.
where you get to mingle with a lot of people. And even post your graduation from your MBA program, it's very important for your networks to actually work out. So I take it as a very valuable resource of mine for working with this many amount of people here, collaborating with them, and to interact with them on a day-to-day basis. It's been amazing. Like, for example, I understood a different way of how alumni are being used in MBA mm-hmm. campuses, specifically in terms of placements, in terms of them coming down, training the students on what to expect in certain placement interviews, and for them to actually bring their own companies for placements over here and to reach out as mentors to the students has been a wonderful experience for me specifically. And when you look at notable alumni that are over here, I think we've got Neha Saraf, who is actually the director of Visa in Singapore. Then we've got Sharda Batra, who's the VP of HR in Singapore for the company called Morgan Stanley.
Mm-hmm.
And we also have Jayaram Rajaram, who is the director and partner in Brill and Elsa Learning Private Limited. It's been a wonderful experience for me to actually interact with the alumni.
All right. How does one get into this wonderful institute?
For a PGDM program or a PGPM program, you can go through the normal way for you write CAT, SAT or CMAT
mm-hmm.
and the scores are valid for 1 year
mm-hmm.
and if you're writing GMAT, the scores are valid for 5 years.
Mm-hmm.
We didn't have an essay to actually write. We didn't have a GD. From the essay, we went to the personal interview round where we have our professors actually take our interviews and then we get to meet them in person once we come to the campus.
All right. So Ashi, it's been nice talking to you. I'm really loving this whole campus and the aura and the vibe it gives me is amazing. I can totally understand what you guys really enjoy and how it helps you in studies. But I'm really thirsty right now and I would not mind a cup of coffee after hearing all this. So can we go somewhere?
So we have a special cafe over here and it's called the Bajaj Bistro. I think mm-hmm. we should have the coffee from there.
All right. Let's go there.
So usually this is the spot that we usually come when we have a break from our classes.
Uh-huh.
Have a cup of coffee, get revitalized and energized and then get back to class again.
And you guys have a CCD, not bad.
Yeah.
So I see an exciting lineup where students can actually go abroad and continue their studies. What is the program about? How is it structured? And what are the kind of experiences that students get?
So in addition to the PGPM program that Great Lakes offers, we also have an option to do the foreign exchange program, and we have a tie-up with this the university called Bordeaux University of Management in France.
Mm-hmm.
And in this program, this is specifically tailored post term 7, that is the last term, and you have a 6-week program in the university itself, and it's an advanced management course where you get to spend time with the students over there, interact with the faculty there as well, and have an experience from a cultural perspective as well. When you look at your job scene after placements, it's mostly towards a multinational company and you deal with clients from varied backgrounds.
Mm-hmm.
And it is very important that you have a business acumen and also a perspective to accommodate different nationalities and different people in that background. And when you have a program like this, it trains the students to be well equipped for the business world from an international perspective.
What are the kind of companies that come in Great Lakes for summer internship?
Some notable companies that offer internships were like Royal Bank of Scotland, McKinsey. We also had JP Morgan giving internship to students, and this gives them well exposure to our business environment when they have an internship in these companies, and they convert these internships to an actual job, and that is very helpful for the campus as well as the students as well. And as far as placement is concerned, for PGDM the average comes around to 10.25, and on a median it's around 10.5 lakhs. And for PGPM, we have, the average placement package comes around to 13.1, and highest is around 29 lakhs. And we have, variety of corporates that come for placements over here. For example, we have Deloitte that comes over here. We have Accenture Strategy and Technology as well. Mm-hmm. We have ZS Consultants. We have EY. We have Cognizant. And there are so many other firms that come here for placements, and they make sure they come to campus again and again because they find good talent over here. And when you have an alumni base in the company as well, it works into your favor.
So Ashish, I go into a lot of campuses. A lot of campuses are known for the kind of domains that they specialize in. What is it like for Great Lakes? Where does the interest lie for students over here?
When you look at the college here itself, the analytics program is one of the best in the world actually. So the college has a very specific program that's called the AIM Lab program. So in this program, what we concentrate is towards artificial intelligence, machine learning, analytics and blockchain. And so you have very diverse set of professionals who've been working in this specific field who come into the campus to upskill themselves in this field again. Mm-hmm. And I'm one of them. So personally, my interest lies towards AI-based voice assistants, and I've been working in specific projects in this campus that is aimed towards clinical lab assistants. Apart from analytics that's over here, there is a lot of students that are also interested in marketing as well. Mm-hmm. And specifically, I've come across a lot of go-to-market strategies, consumer behavior, then different marketing strategies for different products that are there. And one thing that I really like is our dean, Dr. Suresh Ramnathan. Has been involved with Chicago Boot School, and also he's been involved with the Texas May School of Business. One of my favorite professors is Professor Sinu Srinivasan, who's taken consumer-focused product planning for me. And Sinu Srinivasan, sir, is basically the Adams Distinguished Emeritus Professor from Stanford. Mm-hmm. And he is the person who introduced conjoint analysis to the world. My favorite professor in analytics is Professor P.K. Vishwanathan. And he's one of the top 10 data scientist academians in the country.
Oh, okay.
And I think I have to give a shout out to Professor Sriram, because he's an expert who's been in the industry for quite some time. He's worked with a lot of corporates and then come into the industry. And also we have Professor Suresh Srinivasan, who's taking strategy for us. I'm just humbled by this entire thing, to be with them and to just learn from the best in the country. Yeah.
All right, Ashish, it was nice talking to you. I wish that you fill your bowl from Great Lakes, and when you go out, step out, you can use this learning that you have acquired over the year here, and you can put it to the best use. And all the very best for your future, and thank you for this amazing tour. It was nice talking to you.
Thanks so much, Paul. Likewise.
So that is it for today, guys. Tell us in the comment section below how you like the episode. If you like the video, please hit the like button, share it with your friends, and tell them about this wonderful college. And if you really want to know more about these schools, please subscribe to our channel on YouTube.